Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, dame e gospodo. 30 years ago, on 15th January 1992, when a considerable number of countries, including Austria, recognized Croatia, I was serving at the Austrian Embassy in Belgrade, which was my first posting abroad. And I remember quite well that some of my colleagues used to get pretty concerned after statements by the then Austrian Foreign Minister Alois Mock, who was a very strong advocate of Croatian independence and took an explicit and frank stance on the events in former Yugoslavia. Because we were not sure how the authorities in Belgrade would react. Alois Mock was one of those visionary European politicians who realized that the changes that were going on in Europe's east and southeast could not be stopped. I would like to extend a heartfelt welcome to all of you who are marking this 30th anniversary of diplomatic relations with us. Srdačna dobrodošlica svima koji danas prisustvuju ovom jubilejnom koncertu. I am particularly pleased that many of my colleagues here, and I want to thank also the Erste, ich danke der Ersten, for supporting this concert and for making it possible, and also to the Austrian Cultural Forum and the Music Academy. They also contributed to this musical evening tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, I did not expect to witness another cruel war on European soil on my most probably last posting abroad. As a former Austrian ambassador to Ukraine, I'm deeply saddened by the brutal and senseless aggression against that country. The deep desire of Ukrainians, now be they Russian or Ukrainian speaking, for freedom, democracy, and what we would call a normal life, simply cannot be stopped and crushed by military force. This war has already inflicted so much pain and so much damage to people and claimed so many lives. I would like to invite you, if you allow, to observe a minute of silence in memory of the victims of the dreadful war in Ukraine. Thank you so much. The common past of Croatia and Austria, as well as Austria's support for Croatia's independence and Croatia's accession to the EU, has created a solid foundation for our bilateral ties. And Croatia is one of the most popular holiday destinations of my countrymen. Almost 100,000 Croatian citizens live and work in Austria, with an investment volume of 4.5 4 billion euros. The Austrian business is investor number two in Croatia. 30 years after the establishment of diplomatic relations between our two countries, we are strong and cordial partners in a united Europe. Today, the mission of our two countries, as well as the other EU member states, is more than ever to work together to make our European values victorious everywhere in Europe and beyond our continent. Tonight's concert is only one event in a series of celebrations on the occasion of the 30th anniversary of our diplomatic ties. With this year's activities, we want to highlight that bilateral relations are not a one-way, but a two-way street. And that's why we decided to invite young Croatian artists who study at the Academy of Music here in Zagreb to perform works by Austrian and Croatian composers. Another anniversary event is the exhibition Almost of works of the Austrian architect, photographer and artist Wojciech Czaja, which has been on display in several Croatian cities already. During the first COVID lockdown, when traveling was impossible, Wojciech Czaja was exploring Vienna on his Vespa scooter and discovered many places in his hometown that resembled to other cities. And this exhibition inspired us to initiate the campaign Almost Austria here in Croatia. So if you come across buildings, views, images that you associate with Austria, we would like to invite you also to take a picture and post it on social media using hashtag Almost Austria. But now I invite you to listen to our talented young musicians. Have a nice and great musical evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. večer, dragi gosti. Veselimo se što ćemo večeras ovim koncertom proslaviti 30 godina našeg prijateljstva. Guten Abend, liebe Gäste. Wir freuen uns, dass wir mit diesem Konzert 30 Jahre unserer Freundschaft feiern können. Večerašnje glazbeno druženje započeli smo Haydnovim biserom kovane glazbe, koji je inspiraciju našao u narodnom napjevu gradišćanskih Hrvata Jutro rano ja se stanem. Nije to bila jedina hrvatska pjesma koja se svidjela Haydn. Inspiraciju za jednu od njegovih najpoznatijih simfonija našao je u narodnoj pjesmi O Jelena, Jelena, jabuko zeleno. Nastavljamo naš glazbeni program Schubertovim noturnom, koji je on jednostavno nazvao Adagio, a muzikolozi su ga kasnije preimenovali u noturno. Skladao ga je u posljednjoj godini svoga kratkog, ali nestvarno plodnog života. Spomenimo samo preko 400 pjesama za glas i klavir ili brojne skladbe za različite komorne sastave.
Thank you.
Budući da je večeras otpala posljednja točka zbog bolesti izvođača, sada ćemo poslušati Mahlerov klavirski kvartet u A-molu. Jedan od danas najpopularnijih klasičnih kompozitora nije bio priznat od struke i kolega za svojeg životnog vijeka. Početkom 20. stoljeća, u doba novih stremljenja i stilova, smatrali su ga pretjerano romantičnim i neinovativnim. Zato današnja publika hrli u dvorane kada je na programu Mahlerova simfonija. Često čujemo njegovu glazbu u filmovima, a njegov život je podloga za brojna kazališna i filmska uprizorenja. Profesor na odsjeku za dirigiranje Muzičke akademije u Zagrebu, Ivan Josip Skender, dio je svog školovanja proveo na Bečkom Univerzitet für Musik und Darstellende Kunst. Sklada za komorne sastave, zborska i orkestralna djela, a njegova opera Šuma Striborova imala do sad čak 27 izvedbi. Večeras ćemo čuti pet kratkih stavaka za klavirnet, violončelo i klavir.
Thank you.
što smo se danas družili uz glazbu i do nove prigode srdačno vas pozdravljam. Danke, dass Sie heute bei uns waren und bis zu einem neuen Anlass grüßen wir Sie herzlich.